By 1942, the task of battlefield and medium-range tactical reconnaissance in the Luftwaffe on the Eastern Front had been taken over almost completely by Focke Wulf's twin-boom Fw-189. Named the Owl, its large expanse of glazing housing the crew in the small fuselage section saw it quickly nicknamed the Flying Eye. The 189 rapidly proved itself to be highly effective, providing intelligence not just of local enemy dispositions for the benefit of artillery and Stukas, but also of longer-range targets employed for planning the raids of the medium bombers. In the face of such a rapidly changing battlefield situation, photo intelligence of the movement and disposition of enemy forces became a priority. Fw-189s of the recce units were extensively employed in the short to medium range surveillance of the battlefield to garner the information required by Luftwaffe staff planning the next sorties. Very close contact was therefore necessary with the rapidly advancing ground units, and in the absence of radio, the Fiesler Stork was frequently used to take orders to the front line and carry information about forthcoming Luftwaffe operations. The Stork was a highly regarded type. For the poor ground crews keeping the bombers flying in the face of such high sortie rates, the conditions that they were forced to endure when carrying out essential maintenance were appalling. Few of the airfields used were purpose-built, and in the absence of hangars, major equipment changes, such as the replacement of this engine on a Ju-88, had to be carried out in the open, come blizzards, intense frosts, and severe temperatures as low as 30 to 50 degrees below zero. Quite often, the appalling weather prevented the arrival of supplies and spares, and on many occasions, replacing an engine meant cannibalizing another aircraft that had been badly damaged to provide the necessary spares to enable another to be returned to service. It is small wonder that many Luftwaffe pilots, when talking about their own exploits, have made frequent warm references to the valiant efforts of the black men in keeping their aircraft flying, whatever the circumstances.